artists like to go on a countryside retreat to foster their creative process. For Cuba Sander Gonzalez, there is no better place to sketch than several meters below the surface of the sea, surrounded by iridescent Caribbean fish and fantastical coral forms. The 42-year-old is renowned at home and abroad for his predominantly black and white haunting images of imaginary cityscapes inspired by a trip to Europe and reflecting the aggressiveness of modern urban life. Then, 6 years ago, he went scuba diving in Cuba and found his inspiration in the complete opposite, the tranquility found below water, where all forms are natural and not man-made. All sounds are muffled and the light ripples softly. While Gonzalez had heard of a biologist painting underwater in Spain, he decided to experiment for himself until he found a way of sketching with charcoal or oil paints, which, unlike pastels or watercolor, would not dissolve. The Cuban learned to then soak the canvases for at least an hour and rinse them to get rid of the salt and any organic matter before hanging them out to dry.
Esto empezó como una...
This started as a hobby, as a passion. I never thought it would develop this way. It all started, honestly, as an experiment. I'm an artist, as a painter, as a creator. I think any medium is valid. Not everyone tries underwater.
To do so, he gets fully kitted out in scuba diving gear, including an oxygen tank and yellow flippers, and swims out 197 feet to his easel, fixed in the seabed around 20 feet below the surface. With him, he carries his canvas and other equipment, like a spatula for the oil paints, weighed down with some lead to avoid it floating to the surface if he lets go. The artist said he does not plan beforehand, instead allowing inspiration to strike as he enters a meditative state in the crystalline water. But inevitably, his submarine work is more about nature than the cityscape series he continues to develop on land.
I really didn't expect to see somebody underwater painting a nice painting of a whale while I was diving. That actually was really kind of neat. And something I haven't seen before.
Gonzalez, who makes a living selling work at his studio in Havana for a median price of $1,000 per canvas, exhibits some of his submarine work at the Punta Perdiz Dive Center. He is now hoping to get state permission to sell the work and develop the area as a center for underwater art. Nina Armilio, UNTV, News and Rescue.